Now, your KSBW weather forecast with meteorologist Gina DeVecchio.
Happy finish to the weekend, everyone. Taking a look in Salinas, you can see the blue sky getting replaced by the low clouds, which honestly, on a weekend like this, the marine layers are a friend. I know a lot of you enjoy it all the time. Personally, I like that heat, but not when many of our friends in California are seeing over 100 degrees. I'll take this 63 and sunshine with a few clouds moving in. A little bit of a breeze, though, so that wind coming in from the north-northwest at 16 miles per hour, that's what's been keeping us a little on the cooler side today, and that's definitely noticeable inland, where those temperatures, instead of being in the upper 90s, we're only in the upper 80s to low 90s, and we're going to see that cooling trend continuing. Upper 50s right now in Santa Cruz. The temperatures have cooled off. You can see some people still enjoying the beach weather with sunshine, but you can also see the marine layer in the distance. That's going to return, and we are going to be seeing clouds once again this evening and probably some drizzle as well, similar to yesterday evening. Temperatures for today in the Santa Cruz Mountains, lots of mid-80s. So yesterday we had lots of mid-90s, so just as expected, 5 to 10 degrees cooler there. Look at that, though. Capitola and Aptos cool in the mid-60s with the sea breeze. Santa Cruz did reach the low 70s today, and at the coast, upper 60s. So cool there. You can see 60s to 70s for our coastal communities. Watsonville, Prunedale, mid-70s. Romas as well. And then it did get warm, 94 for Morgan Hill. But remember, yesterday, if you were watching, that was our hottest spot at 101. So a little sea breeze kept that a little bit more comfortable, but still mid-90s. Then you can see down the Salinas Valley, lots of mid-80s to low 90s. And then around the peninsula, mid-60s. Carmel, a little bit warmer than yesterday at 65, 71 in Monterey. And just like yesterday, that was only for 1 hour's reading that it got into the low 70s. The rest of the day was in the upper 60s. Here you can see the satellite from today showing the clouds returning in the overnight, beginning to seep into some of our inland valleys. And you can see that for our low clouds and fog future cast. Also need to mention the drizzle. Looks like it's going to be a little heavier throughout this evening. And in fact, this forecast model showing that with the green on the map. So be prepared for that for your Monday morning commute. Also, lots of clouds, a little deeper of a marine layer, meaning it may linger a little longer into the day tomorrow. Here's that wind that's been keeping us cool. You can see lots of teens on there, a little gusty at some areas as well. And then you can see the map right now cooling down. Soledad is the hottest spot at 82 right now, and everyone's cooler. Look at that. Gilroy, 22 degrees cooler. And then you can see that we still have this heat advisory. That's through this evening. Really, the big concern is in the pink, where they are going to be seeing those temperatures over the next couple of hours, not cooling down much. Ridge of high pressure keeping us warm one more day, and then looks like tomorrow we'll start a cooling trend. 60s for San Francisco, 80s in the South Bay, more 80s for the Santa Cruz Mountains. Coastal communities just a few degrees cooler. Watsonville, instead of those mid to low 70s, looks like upper 60s. Salinas as well, instead of the mid 70s and sunshine, you'll be back into the 60s. So a little cool to mild near the coast, and then you can see we do start to warm up again at the end of the week into next weekend with 60s to 80s returning, 90s returning inland. So appreciate that little bit of a natural cool down we'll have the next couple of days.
All right. Thank you, Gina. Mm-hmm.